It's summertime, and I'm back with a new haircut. So, back in the caravan, doing some bits here and there. So, finishing the toilet. I've cut one piece here, one there. So that's nice looking. And here I had a gap, so I'm like, need to cut another piece. And another small piece here. And now it's ready for siliconing. Except this bit, I don't know what to do about this just now. Maybe I'm gonna cut the square thing like that. Or angle it. I don't know. Yeah, or like a 90 degree wall finishing thing from plastic and just silicone that in. But in the meantime, I could do the walls and these things. Ding, and make this waterproof once and for all. I've stepped here and this cracked. But my plan is to put resin on top of this anyway. So maybe that's gonna work. Not too sure how to do with the resin and the drain. I'll get to that. Some cleaning here and there, especially around the toilet, and then silicone. Silicone. Find this tune. Still need to shave a bit from it.
Maybe like 1 centimeter.
What do you know? Boom. I just need to cut this lip, obviously. But this should be alright, man. Let's try these cheap silicone ones. I think they're like 99p. Let's give it a go. Right. And for a nice bead, we're gonna go like that. Finger through it later so I make it uniform, but now it's just man, this tube
gremlin on my shoulder right now.
Now it's just like a temp thing.
It's not going anywhere.
Testing the wet finger method. Let's see. Fill this like that. How about them apples? There's been massive work done. I had assistance. So this is painted now. Gray looks amazing. Way better. Way better. So that's painted. We need to finish it here and there. We started with this one, but the toilet, yo. Check out these lines. This is, I still need to clean that, but look. Yo. I've covered this crack also with some silicone. This is way better than I expected, really. All around there, down, down here. That's, I fucked up that one. Here, could use a better one. But, it's happening, that's a mistake. And I started here, look. That's the gap, that's no gap. Nice. I just discovered some pieces. The secret is a wet finger. That's the secret. Imagine that. So wet your fingers first, kids, before doing anything with them. It's gonna be good, I guarantee you. Nice. Nice, nice, really nice. Alright, and now to finish up this door, I was thinking, I still have some of this gasket from that big window. And that gasket can go here, like that. And that should be it, it should keep the water in. The curtain is bigger, so that's gonna work. Nice. And another thing that I didn't show you, check this out. Hey, it's flushing, baby. How cool is this? And then open, bang. Sick. So there's been some more work done. This is gray now. I got more wood like that, and I'm gonna build this shelf here. This, whatever it's gonna be. This is gray. Gray is sweet. I like this gray. And the toilet is done. With one big exception. This thing that was supposed to be silicone or a bathroom sealer. It's soluble in water, if you can imagine that. So when I tested it, when I put some water around, all of this became wet and now it comes off. I don't understand, it was saying it's a bathroom sealer. There's water in bathrooms. It was saying it's good for bathtubs and things. So what I want to do is maybe get some proper silicone and put it on top of this. Which is a pain in the ass because I spend so much time doing this stuff. But it should be simpler now, I'm hoping. Nice. Alright. Another thing that I want to do. I've used some shitty holes for the cold water. And there's no debit. So that's the cold. That's the warm, look, I mean, water should come properly out. So I'm gonna change that shitty hose with this yellow hose that I used to pipe all the caravan with, actually. Yeah, hey. So let's do this. Now hopefully I can remove the hose, the old one, because it goes to the back of the fridge, to the back of this cabinet, on the other side of course, all the way to down there. And I'm saying it's a shitty hose because it's a really soft one and it gets kinked so fast. See, it comes from down there. Now I'm hoping maybe I can tape this hose to that hose, and when I pull it down, it's gonna take this one with it. That would be great. Alright. This. And this. And this. Why didn't I bring the electric screwdriver? So now this comes off. And this is my shitty hose. See? It's kinked already. Fucking holes. And it goes down there. This should be interesting. I might have to remove this and take it off slightly. Just remember the gas pipe is fixed. Sorted, check this out. Hey. Cold, hot, and both. Nice. Behold the beginning of the structure of the kitchen cabinet thingy. That's gonna be here somehow. Like that. And then this here. What I'm thinking is maybe sliding doors as opposed to opening doors, or a little wall here and just a door that could go with a catch on the ceiling or something. Yeah, I think something like a little wall here and then a door that can open. Need to find some hinges, some stuff. I took this as a reference, so this is gonna fit here like that or like this. I don't know how. Alright, mugs, whatever. And here there'll be a little wall. Here there'll be some sheet metal because the gas hob is there, so you don't want to heat the wood too much. Just on this side, the sheet of metal, or these things. I'll have two left, so maybe these things. Yeah. Here, another little wall. A plate underneath. I'll have to unstick this LED strip. Heartbroken. But it's gotta go. And probably put it here. Although, it's alright. If it's gonna be there, I think it's calmer. Yeah. If it's here, I'll have to hide it. So, leave it there. Maybe I don't have to unstick it? Yeah, I do. So the wall can go properly on underneath. Alright. That's that. I'll find a 90 degree thingy here, because I can't put a screw in right now. And then that should be it, really. Here we are several hours later. Yes, that's a bit crooked, but the whole thing is kind of weird, so that's okay. Hey, the kitchen cabinet. It's solid. I moved this light switch here. It's pretty great. Stuck it with no more nails. No more nails is a really cool glue, like silicone based glue thingy. I've added another layer of tiling. I moved this a bit higher so I can hang mugs and put cloths to dry and stuff like that, and have it make sense. And it does, and you can turn on the water, blah blah. Okay, for now, I don't know about the door situation. I might just have half shut forever, but then you go like this. I don't know yet. I'll need to think about a door for here, think about a door for there. I have some of this. Another thought was this half table here. Ooh. To make it a door here, like that. Maybe this is gonna work. I don't know yet. I'll need to find some hinges that can accommodate this, really. And then see some kind of spring hinges or some kind of lock here, depending on what I find. I'm gonna make a decision. And yeah, last but not least, I'll put like a balustrade here and here, and get like a tiny mattress, like Max's bed, and then find some cheap rope, because rope is really expensive to put on the corners there to actually finish it. But it's cool, man. Here, I'm thinking to put, I've got two more of these. I'm thinking to stick them. So I'm thinking just to stick them like that. I'll have to cut them because I won't move the LED strips once again. So I'll have to cut them and just stick them here like that. Hopefully they're gonna stay if you stick them. A little bit later, I'm still here. I wanna finish this kitchen unit and then go to sleep. I've added this thing also. I need to add this little triangle, fix this cable here, put a faceplate, cut a faceplate on this, and this will be the door. And you'll have access, you can go in there and in there. In the future, I'll put a light in here also, because 2020. Looks cool. This used to be one of these that covered the sink, but I'll never cover the sink now because I have this, so I'm just gonna leave this like that. Alright, catch you when this is gonna be covered. So here we are at the end of this very productive Sunday. This is the box I made. I still need to like shave a bit of edges here and there, but it's looking like this. That's the door. When it's gonna be painted, you won't be able to see this hinge. That's the door. That's the cupboard. No light at the moment, but it will have. No latch at the moment, but it will have. Hopefully I'll find something like this to fit the rest of the design. Quite cool. Move this light switch here now. There's a lot of condensation forming on this aluminum. But I'm happy. It's going nice. It's going nice. Ah, I've put up this table also. I need to clean it, but that's later. So that's a little table. He used to have another one on the other side, but I have this now. So. Okay, this goes like that. Bang. Let's wash my hands. Back in the caravan with this tool. I've realized I have a router, and I could just chamfer all these edges, make them all nice. I got the idea because I hate how this square thing looks, and I think the router is gonna be the best finishing tool I could use for it, actually. So let's get at it. The problem I have with this router is it's gonna generate a lot of mess. I mean, a lot. So from square edge to this kind of edge. Yeah, that's nice. It's not bad. Not bad. So I had the router out for a bit, and it's way better. It doesn't fit here more, but that I can deal with that. It just looks nicer. And here you can tell I was having this as a reference because it went whoop. I don't mind. It's alright. But it looks way nicer with the chamfered edges. Everything does, really. So I'm gonna do the same here. Because I like it. It makes stuff just blend. I'm thinking to do the same thing here. Also, yeah, man. Finally, this cable trunking is installed. Also, the cable management here.
So when we put bags, we don't mess up the wires.
This has been routed also. It's way nicer. Like that. Might I mention, I've cleaned the whole caravan and then I forgot to route this one. And then it became a mess again. Later in the day, I got a bit trigger happy with that router. But man, these round edges look way better than normal. It makes it look like it's a single piece. And here, that's like really good. And then I was like, why not do these also? So I did these. I built the wardrobe. It's gonna have like a little curtain here. We decided there's another shelf here now. And everything's labeled, because that's what you gotta do if you're an engineer. All right, this is rounded also. The router didn't fit here, but it kind of makes, it's nice this, because it's in the same spot here on the bottom. It kind of looks interesting. Couldn't do this lip yet, because, yeah. And then I was like, let's optimize. So I rounded these also. So now the table fits perfectly. I'll make a demonstration in the near future right now. Rounded this also. Now the table fits perfectly. There's a bed and we still have that pillow piece there that I wanna bring it and put it there to see how it looks. All right, and then I was like, let's optimize. So I've labeled everything in here. This is Marc Ravillier, by the way. He's a fucking genius. So I've labeled everything here. Cable tied all the wires nice, so it's all nice. Cable tied this here, so now I can see what's going on with the battery. So you take the table from here, and you slide it in here. Move this mattress. Boom! Perfect, straight. Now, I need to do another piece for here from something. I'll measure it and cut it. And then these go like that. Boom. And this goes like that. And what I was saying to you guys is that I have a long piece for here. I need to get some double-sided Velcro tape or something and put it here. And this is how it looks with that little pillow there. I think it's brilliant. I think it's exactly what it needs. Relax. And it's just chill here. Watch some movies, listen to something. Pretty cool. Hey. It's nearly ready for its maiden voyage. Now I will indulge in these beautiful cupcakes. Thank you, baby. Forgot about the mirror. Bang. This is the mirror. It's detachable. Welcome to my crib. And for the La Pièce de Résistance, how cool is this, yo? Chilling, watching a movie on the projector. Crazy, isn't it? Nice. And if you want sound, you go aux. And you got the sound from the movie. Man, I just made a really cool living space. I like it.